Hello, Mel here with Body Care Boutique, and I am making a soap called Chasing Butterflies, and you'll see why. I just got my oils and clay and all that good stuff here. Okay, and I am going to go ahead and add my lye. I sure like these little containers for lye water. I got these at Cash and Carry. I don't know which states they're in and which they aren't, but they're definitely here in Washington State. But I don't know, you might be able to order them online from them, I'm not sure. They're handy for doing batches that aren't gargantuan. I also have a big one too, but I'm just using mostly the red molds from Essential Depot, that size batch, so I don't need to, you know, do a ton. Okay, what I'm going to do is pour off a little bit for the piped top. I don't want to put fragrance in that. To just stay I just want to stay the pretty color that it is. This fragrance isn't supposed to change anything, but as most of you know, that's not always the case. Sometimes you think a fragrance isn't going to do anything, and it does. So I'm kind of one of those people. I just kind of see how it goes. And since this soap is called Chasing Butterflies, the idea I had in mind for design is the base I want to be green like grass. So that's what I'm doing here. And I totally don't mind if this gets kind of, you know, medium trace. I actually want it to. But like I said, it's one of those fragrances that doesn't speed trace or anything. So it may take a while. In fact, I may have to just kind of pause and let it harden up a bit. I don't want to stand here all day stick blending. So that's a possibility. Yeah, it's not tracing fast. You know, one thing I hate about wearing gloves is that I always tend to get soap right in here, like fresh soap, and it burns me. I mean, the point of gloves is protection, but I actually get burned worse when I'm wearing them than I do when I'm not. So, yeah, kind of crazy. Add the fragrance in here. This fragrance mix just reminds me of being outside, smelling the flowers. It just has a real pleasant kind of floral fragrance. I love it. Not moving quick at all. I've been, I messed with my recipe a little bit, and this is full water, which is great if you're doing, you know, playing around with it, swirling, anything like that, and you need it to not thicken and trace fast, but when you need it to, it takes a while. Well, looks like I could probably do this all day and it still wouldn't thicken up. That's okay. I've got time. If anything, I might burn my stick blender out before this soap hardens up. So, note to self with this recipe. Do it when you don't want it to thicken. Look at that. It's still, it is, gosh, it's not even every bunch of a trace. My stick blender's quite warm in my hand. Could just sit here and sing for you. Would you like that? Probably not. Okay, for all you smart alecks out there, you just keep that comment to yourself, you hear me? Oh, well, this is taking forever. I think I like that green, but you know what? I think of grass. I think of like darker green. So I'm going to put a little more in here. This is this color. It's just a green mica from a company that I used to live by. I just had a thought. What I should do is use my stick blender that's insanely high powered. See if I can get this to thicken up any faster. I might do that. Let's give that a shot. Although I hate the way this thing works. It's got this, the bottom like pops in and out like that. So when you're using it, it can be quite loud. but I think what I'll do, yeah, I can rinse it. I'll just mess. See if we can get this to thicken up. It sounds like it's making a song. A little bit. Now it's at a light trace. So I'm gonna keep going here. You can fast forward. I know this is boring. A very light trace. Good lordy. I could eat lunch while I'm waiting for this. What I went for in this recipe is very conditioning. So, with not doing quite as much of the ingredients that really harden the bar up while you're working with it, obviously made a huge difference. So, I'm not really liking that it takes this long. This is kind of crazy. I've never stick blended this much in all my years of soap making. But my stomach's growling, so I may go make lunch and come back to this. I'm thinking that's probably going to be my best bet because it is not moving very much. Might give it some time to warm up. I can feel it's... It's at 89, so it's still, you know, it's not really hot. It's a little warm, but not much. So, boring! Yeah, like I said, I think I'm going to step away for a bit, give it some time to harden up, and make myself something to eat so my stomach quits growling, and I will be back. Okay, I'm back, and I did make lunch and eat lunch. waiting for this soap. It was actually a quick lunch, quick, easy lunch. Very, very easy to make. In fact, you don't really make anything, you just heat it. You know, like at Costco, you can buy those bags of, look at this, it thickened up a little bit. Those bags of, like stir-fried vegetables that you just have to basically heat up. What I did is just took that and also the Foster Farms chicken strips that are pre-cooked and seasoned. You can buy in the frozen aisle of Costco, and I just, if I want a quick lunch or whatever, I just heat those up, and then you can buy little cups of white rice and you can actually just heat them in the microwave. So that's what I did. Quick and easy. Okay, this is much more of a pourable texture, yay. But I think the, oh, ah, that was messy. I think the portion that I'm going to be using for doing the pipe top isn't ready yet. I have literally, I don't think, ever walked away from soap. I have no idea how this soap's going to turn out, but I'm not super fond of it. I'll just tweak the recipe. Sorry, I'm lip smacking. I'm chewing bubble gum. You know, I think that's something I will never grow out of. I try not to eat it very much because it's just loaded with sugar, but you know, the bubble gum, what am I trying to think of? My blood's going to my stomach to process my food. You know, bubble gum balls. Whenever we go by a machine, yes, at my age, in my 40s, I still make my husband give me change if he has some so I can get a bubble gum. My mom is a blast. She is so much fun. She's an awesome grandma. Was an awesome mom. And you know, she never lost that inner child. And I just think it is so cool because she really instilled in us to just have fun and be silly. You know, my dad is just hilarious. He is so funny, and we always had laughter in our home. Well, let me tell you, we can all fight pretty good. But, you know, we always had laughter. We love hard, we fight hard, I guess, between us. Yeah. I don't know, it's just one of those things that I love about my mom. She's so much fun, and when she sends packages to us, she sends them addressed to everybody, including the pets. Okay, this is going to be loud. All right, get those bubbles up, if any. Anyway, so, yeah, it's just one of those things. I bubble gum. I mean, she still, if we go to dinner with her, or you know, go to a meal and they have a bubblegum machine in the entryway of a restaurant or wherever, she'll stop and pull out change out of her purse and get everybody a bubblegum. Isn't that just too cute? It's just one of those things that, you know, she didn't have a lot of privileges as a child, and so I think, you know, with having so many kids, grandkids, she's kind of living her childhood through us, and I just think that's pretty darn cool, you know. So I am thankful for my mommy, and she is a mommy. She is not just a mom. She's a mommy. I was blessed with wonderful parents. And still get to enjoy them. So, okay, so that is all right. The screaming bird is not all right. That is not cool. But just won't shut up. So, this is still loose. I cannot pipe this. So, I am just going to have to wait until it's ready because I stick blended after I shut the camera off last time, and it helped a little bit, but it's just not ready, so I will be back. Okay, let's do some piping on the chasing butterflies. Soap. And so the green represents like grass. Pink kind of represents flowers. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Perfect. The bottom. That didn't turn out very cool, but it doesn't really matter because I'm going to squishy the tops anyways with these adorable embeds. I have little butterflies in these little feet are just too damn cute. So anyway, that's why I thought of theme for this soap. So let's see, what color was I going to start with? We'll start with blue. Let's see. Yes, there is a method to my madness with these. It's hard to do them backwards. Let's see. Hopefully they won't fall. The batter's not super duper thick, so I'm hoping I can get it to work okay and stay. Please stay. I can squish it over a little bit. Ow. Burning my finger. I know you can't see a ton, but I will show you when I'm done putting these on. I love butterflies. I am a butterfly fanatic. And it's funny, I seem to be noticing more and more butterfly stuff. And my husband even said the other day, he goes, "What is up with that?" Because we seem to be seeing them everywhere and everything. He goes, "What is up with that?" And I said, "It's all for me because I love them." moved over for the little foot that doesn't want to stand up. Stay. Ain't that cute? See if I can get them lined up okay for cutting. I'm gonna have to keep an eye on them because those little feet are wanting to fall over. And let's see. What do I want to do? How about these cute little tiny yellow sugar balls, because they really stand out in the pink. I really like these two because they do make cutting a little bit easier. Make sure they're evenly spread. Yep. And then, of course, we have to have our iridescent glitter. That's just a must with something cute like this. It just makes everything look so cute. Okay, there's the Chasing Butterfly soap. Hope you guys like it. And I will do the cutting videos as soon as, for this soap and the soap I just made, the bubble bath soap. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.